Okay, so you remember the setup. 100 people have had marked dollar bills put randomly into 100 boxes, and every person, one at a time, gets to look in 50 of the boxes, and you all collectively win only if every single person finds their own bill. $100 to each of you if you win? Nothing if you lose. In the last video, I asked whether or not you should take the bet. Did you make the right choice? I mean, clearly, if all 100 of you gamblers just choose 50 boxes at random when you go into the room, the likelihood of each of you finding your bill is 1/2. So the probability of all of you finding your bills and winning the whole game is 1/2 times 1/2 times 1/2 100 times. And 1/2 to the power of 100 is about 0.000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 then pick the King of Hearts at random out of a deck of cards. You could do a little better by trying to correlate which boxes you pick. Like, if there were only two people and two boxes, they should each pick different boxes, because if they pick the same box, only one of them can possibly find their own bill, and they'll automatically lose. But this kind of correlation strategy only improves your odds a tiny little bit, and has less and less benefit the more people there are. This is not looking good for the gamblers. However, it turns out that there is a strategy that results in the gamblers winning over 30% of the time. This strategy is so good that you're more likely to win using it than if just two people out of 100 picked randomly, since a half times a half is 25%, and this strategy wins 30% of the time. What we've forgotten to think about is that you can obtain information from the boxes themselves, because the room is exactly the same each time. The first box will always have the same numbered dollar in it, so will the second box, the third, the 57th, etc. All you have to do is use the dollar in one box to tell you which box to go to next. This might not seem like a great advantage, but it's huge. The trick is to start with the box that corresponds to your number. Your dollar probably isn't in that box, but the bills inside will take you on a random path through the boxes, a scavenger hunt where each box tells you where to go next. You can think of this as linking up boxes in chains, connecting them based on the bills inside. Any random arrangement of the boxes results in a different set of chains, and in each set, some chains will be long and some small. Short chains are ones like box 30 says go to box 82, box 82 says go to box 5, 5 says go to 30. That's a chain of length 3. Long chains link up more boxes before circling back, and the longest possible chain links up all 100 boxes. No box can be in two different chains because each box only tells you one new box to go to. But each chain always circles back, since there are finite boxes. And of course, if you end up back where you started within 50 boxes, you've won, because that means the previous box had a dollar bill that told you to go to your starting point, and you started on your number, so the previous box's dollar bill was yours. And that's why this strategy is so good, because when we rearrange the boxes randomly, about 30% of the time, there'll be no chains connecting more than 50 boxes. So not only will you win, but so will everyone else, as long as they're following the same strategy. Let me say that again. When you randomly rearrange the boxes, more than 30% of the time, there are no chains of more than 50 boxes. So if you start on your own number and follow the chain, you'll end up at your bill within 50 steps. And so will everyone else. The magic of this solution isn't that it gives better odds for any single individual to find their dollar bill, because it doesn't. It's that all of the successes and failures are forced to happen together. Everyone wins together, everyone loses together. Your fates are linked by using the numbers inside the boxes to guide you along invisible chains, towards victory. This video is supported in part by our Subbable subscriber iFixit.com, the world's free online repair manual with free step-by-step repair guides to fix all your stuff, from the bicycle you ride to the smartphone in your pocket. Check out iFixit.com/minutephysics for repair manuals, parts, and tools so you don't have to throw away what you can fix.